Hey, what's up? You want to be like me, have a big beard? Do what I do. Here's what I do. Five habits. Do them with me. It'll be awesome. Strange intros aside, what's going on, guys? My name is Noah. In this video, we're going to talk about five habits that have completely changed my life that I've adopted into my day-to-day practice. Number one, I read every single day and I make a habit out of doing it first thing in the morning. It has to be non-fictional. I set a timer for at least 30 minutes. And I do this because I believe that by constantly ingesting wisdom, nutritional information, guidance, leadership, information from thought leaders and successful people around the world, I'm always then in a space to challenge my own thinking and sort of corner myself to grow and think bigger than I'm able to otherwise. This to me guarantees that I will not get stuck in my own ways for too long at a time. I prioritize it because I believe in the why of it. Number two, in the habits that have changed my life forever, tracking my food. Until I started tracking my food, I was basically always eating more than I thought I was eating. And I've heard other people say that they found out they were eating way less than they meant to be eating. But I personally have tons of physical goals because I believe my physical goals and my physical practices play directly into my mental health goals, my mental health practices. And food is one of those ways that affects everything. Everything. And in my quest to be an accountable adult, I found that by just tracking my food, even if there's no diet, which I hate that word, but no diet associated with it, I tend to make healthier, more mindful choices. And when I come into a problem or find I'm in a rut or I'm no longer making progress, I have information that can allow me to make changes. Number three for habits that have really, really impacted my life is meditating in the shower. Many of us have heard that we should meditate as a part of my Western upbringing. It didn't come up much when I was a kid. I didn't know anyone that meditated. I wasn't aware if my parents were akin to this practice. And I just didn't necessarily buy into it. It was more made fun of than it was promoted. But it is something that has come up so much in my adult life that I felt I was not utilizing, that I finally became willing to investigate what way can I implement this ancient practice that can really help calm the body, calm the thoughts, it has an effect on your mental, emotional health as well as your physical health. How can I do it? And for me, that was meditating in the shower. Finding shower meditation was a game changer for me because what do I do every day regardless? I'm gonna shower. I'm lucky enough to have access to warm water and a nice shower. So now I literally bathe my body and then I sit down on the floor and I take some deep breaths and I breathe in colors and words and affirmations in a thing called, or using a modality called square breathing. Meditating in the shower, huge game changer for consistency. Number four, daily affirmations. I struggle with self-worth badly. And it's been quite the epiphany to find out I'm the only one on earth who struggles with that. It's just me out here. With poor self-esteem, I have sought things like drugs, alcohol, sex, food, and just about anything external to feel better about myself. And as many of you know, those things don't last. Those things aren't pure and organic. They're fleeting and artificial. So I had to do something that was going to daily frame my thinking to be proud of myself and allow me to take on a new identity. And for me, that is affirmation. So every single day, without fail, because I believe in this so much and I believe in the importance of my self-esteem being healthy, I write down positive affirmations such as, I believe in myself today. I am worth loving today. I am healthy and trim today. I am a lean athlete. I am good enough. I love you, Noah. I am worth it. I am smart enough. I am capable of being disciplined. Adult responsibility for me is non-negotiable. I need to start speaking this language and reading this language coming out of myself every single day so I can start absorbing and adopting that power of belief, that power of intention, that power of my new truth. I can't tell you how many ways this plays out positive. Like when I do those daily affirmations and then I think of skipping a workout, for example, I remind myself, oh, I'm a disciplined person and I honor my body. That's part of my affirmations. I'm going to the gym. That's who I am now. I'm speaking it and I'm living it into reality. Same thing can go for anything. I start telling myself I'm not smart enough, I'm stupid. Oh, Noah, no you're not. I'm not someone who bashes himself. Why? Because self-love and responsibility is non-negotiable to me. I put that in my affirmations. This is who I am now. And I'm allowing myself to cultivate a new identity. And I believe affirmations and showing yourself how tenderness is so important and so overlooked, perhaps especially among men. Among men. I don't want to afford anyone kindness and love and respect and the benefit of the doubt that I'm not going to afford myself. I treat me real nice now. Number 5 is nightly walks with my wife. This habit has been such a game changer for winding down in the evening and for reconnecting with my wife and my best friend. I don't believe you have to go with someone. I think going for a nightly walk is just this really powerful, easy way to get out of our controlled, sterile environment and into nature. I struggle getting into nature, and that's an easy way that I can do it. Since that has become a habit over the last year with my wife to do a nightly walk with our dogs, I just find that it's such a nice space to get some good circulation, some fresh air, and some authentic one-on-one non-distracted time with my wife. It is like a love nurturer for both of us. I mean, we decompress, we talk, we're free. We just love one another on those walks. And I feel really close to my wife on those walks, and we look forward to those walks. Just love walking with her. I'm getting moving with my walk. I'm chatting with my wife. My dogs are gonna poop. That makes me feel real nice. So. Those are just 5 habits in no particular order that have been really, really, really game changing for me in all seriousness. Pick any old thing that you might start doing daily, whatever you feel like would be the path of least resistance, and start stacking habits. Habits, when stacked upon one another, good habits, they create complete and lasting change in people, not thoughts. You're not your thoughts, you are your actions, and your actions are usually dictated by your daily habits. And these are some things that I do every single day. In the comments below, please let me know what are some habits that have really changed your life. Do you believe in the power of habit? Please share with me. I love learning from you guys. I'm so thankful for you guys being here, making my life better, and I cannot wait to see you in the next video. I have a major announcement for you guys. I almost did it now, but I feel like I hadn't offered anything that might be of use to you in a while in terms of like, this is good for you, so do it. So I wanted to share this video. Welcome to all the new subscribers. You don't know how much you mean to me either. And we'll see you guys in the next one. Again, my name is Noah. This is my Mexican stash. We'll see you in the next video. For whatever it's worth, soy medio mexicano, mi mamá es chicana. So I'm not like trying to be racist or anything. I literally am half Mexican. I just look super Jewish.